All right, today's project is going to be building a removable table, workbench table, motorcycle lift, lawnmower lift, go-kart lift, whatever you want to call it, lift, for the ideal mobile lift from our friends in the Orient. I think it was $3,300-ish. It was over $3,000. Can't say too many bad things about it. Other than that, I don't use it enough, and the cylinder was pitted from sitting in a cargo crate for who knows how long before it came stateside, and it blew the O-ring out, so I had to have the cylinder rehoned with no warranty. And it's a China off-brand, so it's 9 months to get that cylinder replaced, but the rebuild kit's holding as of 5 months now. I just cycle it up and down more often than I used to. All right, I'm into these plans for a total of about 2 minutes. This is kind of my rendering I came up with. I want it 4 feet wide, at least 7 feet long. Making it out of metal, primarily. Went to the local weld shop. Believe it or not, $195.28 worth of metal. Thanks, Joe. I'm going to utilize these basically building these of this just like that, so it'll be somewhat removable. Let the fun begin. That's kind of the general shape. These arms are pushed in all the way. That gives me a 4 foot width. I'm going to keep these tucked in because majority of my weight be my motorcycle, which would be, you know, more towards the front. I suppose I could shift that down a little bit because these are adjustable. I just figured if I had them pushed in, it'd be easier to get the closer measurements. Kind of a failure. I cut the first ones at 2 inches. These are 3.5. Just in case I want to put a hole in the bottom so I can put a pin through to attach it so the table or working platform won't fall off. So what my goal is to basically build this. This is what comes factory with the lift. We got different heights for different type cars or different applications. That's where I got my different pipe. And now I'm just trying to figure out the right height because I want to utilize it where it rests on the factory hoist up in the front, and then have my beam going across right there And then also right here, so it doesn't look too bad, but issue may arise between there for some reason. I don't know why I'm thinking. When in doubt, you know, it's hard to figure out what's square because there's so many different variables. What's not a variable is the front. I'm just going to butt it up right here, both sides, and just clamp the piss out of this. Obviously, try and keep this distance same on both sides and rack it one way or another. See how close the Chinese were at when they built this thing. Six and three eighths. So using these factory spacers is actually laying out really nice. If you can see, they have a, let's look at each other. You got that milled out so that these bumpers, you can adjust the height. So I'm basically utilizing that as like a factory edge. So I turn that, kick that in. Holds it in there nice and straight. I think I'm going to utilize that exact height. Pretty much matches that to whatever the lift is doing with how it's sitting on the ground. So I think I'm going to utilize that height there and up here. Again, wanting to kind of have that sit right there. You can see I got to build this spacer that height. If that makes any sense. Here's my little hack. Those are to lift that off the ground. This gets me a little bit more in case I want to put a hole in there to pin these down. I did make it a little bit higher because I figured if anything, this lift does tend to tweak down. Well, I got my first mistake. This is looking beautiful in the back. Nothing's mocked up yet, but that's gonna be an issue. Because I want the load carried on here. Well, this has got a lot of play, and I don't know, it wasn't quite seated properly, but I mean, that's a solid 3/16. So basically, it's even worse on that side. So I gotta make those again, which is nice. All right, I built them again, and I just tacked them. See, they're nut tight now. Dang, this one's a little high, which I can grab. grind off. All right, I got it all tacked up. Try not to get too much heat to it. It's kind of getting a little bit tweaked, but she sits down once you kind of get some weight on it. Too cheap. I just have a gasless wire and it's junk. So it is what it is. Gotta flip it over and kind of burn the pipes on. Just adding some additional structural support. Run all the way up here. I'm gonna get a Harbor Freight wheel chalk set up here, so I don't know how I'm gonna frame this in yet. I'm just gonna run some lateral bracing. So I was just looking at this, wondering why that thing's sitting so cocky. And then it hit me. So that's a big one there. F my life. Somehow I burned that small one on when it should have been that one. Now I gotta cut that sucker off. Burn that bitch on. Story of my life. Yeah, I don't know how these got mixed up. Probably stopping, starting, starting, stopping. Kind of getting this project done in one day. But now I need to grind that off, weld him on, match that side to make it even. All right, we got her off. I gotta flip it around. That's as far as I'm taking it tonight. If it's a million times better, imagine that when you have the same spacers. Just a little bit of a twist. But sitting on there, just a little bit of play there. I mean, just a hair. Still might add some supports, like right there and there. Maybe a bar. Still keep it. Definitely need to pin it.
So here's the two options I have.
This one or this one. I like that this one goes forward and bolts a little bit further back, because my table's pretty short.
need that much adjustment. We'll try this one.
All right, unboxing. Wheel chop, $37. Member price. Looks legit. Looks like there's four mounting points. I went with this one simply because I want to have that as far forward as possible. It's got a short runway here. So it looks like I gotta add in some supports. So just thinking to myself, obviously I have a front fender on my bike. I'm gonna have to dig my bike out and make sure that I have proper clearance here before I just go ahead and throw this old dog all the way forward. So that means White Knight's coming out. To that goddamn rotor. I guess we'll see. A little dirty. Just cut some angle iron. Measured it. Gonna tack it up. All right, I got that burned in there. Now, I did pick up a piece of 5/8 plywood for $42. Thanks, Joe. $37 for a half inch. I figured for the extra $5. Throw that on there and just kind of clamp it down and see what we're dealing with. Fairly straight. All right, just kind of got it clamped down. It's fairly straight. Good enough for what I need it for. Just got some 2-inch carriage bolts. I'm gonna pop it down. I decided to go with wood just in case, you know, I ever want to change it out, I can easily. Yeah. Six bolts holding it down. Would have been a hump right there, but all right, time to mount this bad boy. A little bit of math. Obviously the table's 48 divided by 2, 24. Ten and 3/8. And it's hard to see my lines. Center line with the chalk. I knew that raising this up 5/8 of an inch would allow me to go that much more forward, but it is going to be kind of conflicting, so I'm just going to shift it back slightly just so I can get in that. Not going to my 1x tube, but in my angle iron is my game plan. four holes and cross your fingers. All right, I got the four holes popped in. Don't know exactly where they fell. They should be on the angle iron. So that's the lame-ass hardware that they give you. And they want this spacer to go in there. I don't want to be dicking around with that all the time. I'll probably just put some underneath, but I'm going to flip this over, get some better nuts, weld my nuts on there so I can just run a regular leg so I can easily bolt and remove this thing when I want to instead of dicking around all the time with this crap. Stand by. Remember when I said it's never easy? I gotta kind of whack that out. That one's good. That one's dog shit. Dog shit. Should have had that shifted over that way a little bit, but just gonna whack this down. Whack that, whack that. All right, they'll allow me to weld some nuts on there. All right, so what I did is flipped it over. Obviously, I notched those. It looks like I didn't even have to notch some of these, but I just got a little buck wild, went for it. I got it mounted upside down. Gonna flip it back over, set it in place, make sure, because this has got a fair amount of play. I just don't want those nuts messed up. Because once I weld those nuts in, I'm not... I don't want to have to grind them off. So, let's see what happens. All right, got it flipped over. Seems to be holding true. All right. Burn these nuts on. Got a rag standing by because I don't want these to get too hot. Warp. See what happens. Kind of got them tacked on there. You don't want to go too crazy. These aren't the bolts that I'm going to use. Just kind of some throwaways. So I'm going to run them in up and down a couple times, clean out the if there's any warpage going on. All right, one final overview before I flip this pig over, because I don't want to keep flipping it back, because now I'm basically done underneath, unless I have to add a little landing back here if my rear tire hangs over or is just a hair short. I don't want to have to do that, but I might have to. You can see I made basically, I copied the factory inserts to go in the slots, heights in the rear are obviously higher than the back. It's nice when a plan, comes together. It's just so easy just bolting this thing down now. I did put those spacers in there just to kind of support it for the moment. I don't want to go too crazy. All right, she down. All right, here goes nothing.
So I'll be able to whack it off, no problem.
Well, might as well let it rip. Better protect the truckster. All right. Oh, it seems awfully tight. I know this is adjustable right here. And I'll put some eyelets on the side so that I can forget about the kickstand when it's up. It's just gonna make life so much easier. It seems to be sitting fairly level. You know, it's sitting flat on the pegs that I made. Fun little project. A couple tweaks, maybe take a sander, kind of smooth up the edges, whack the tail off, maybe use the piece for a ramp. That's it. So here's the final project as far as I'm going to take it. I did end up putting in just some supports there, so when you step on it, it is super, super, literally no movement whatsoever. Did put a couple eye bolts on both sides, boom there, and right there. Just kind of rounded off the edges, but it sits nice and tight in everything. It's fairly level. Try to clean up anything where, that's pretty sharp yet, but for the most part, I tried cleaning up all of the edges. If I have to move it off, yeah, I mean, this thing sits fairly well. That one's got a little space in it, but you know, it's at least that way. I can get my zero turn on here without having to move the wheel chock, so that's perfect. Other than that, I don't know what I'd really put on there. Maybe a snowblower or something, just anything to work on. Nothing's going to be longer than my motorcycle, I don't think. Maybe a snowmobile, I guess. But that's it. Hope you enjoyed the series.